having a cell phone while black.
Sleeping while black.
Like Botham Jones been in our apartment while black. But her son was killed while at the church while black. And she did not think it robbery, Arthur, to come here and be with Andrew Brown's family. So like Miss Gwen Carr, we thank her and we continue to pray for justice for your son as well.
For the sixth day in a row, protesters taking to the streets of downtown Elizabeth City, North Carolina, demanding answers and accountability. It's been nearly a week since Andrew Brown Jr. was shot and killed by deputies, and his family still feels left in the dark, telling us they were promised they'd see the body cam video showing Brown's final moments, but were only shown 20 seconds from a single camera, even though there were multiple deputies at the scene wearing body cameras.
Describe it. What did you see in those 20 seconds?
Execution. We see his hands on the steering wheel while they were shooting, actually.
They selectively edited a video, cut it down to 20 seconds, showed us what they wanted to show us, and blurred out the faces of the officers.
We're going to make them release this video so it can be transparent. They cannot continue to try to sweep this under the rug. The whole world is watching Elizabeth City.
Do you believe they're not going to release any of the video to the public?
No, we believe they're going to release all the video to the public because we're going to demand it. We're going to make them release it. They don't want to release it. Had it not been for all of us standing for justice for Andrew Brown, they probably would have never released that video anytime soon. It would be reminiscent of Laquan McDonald in Chicago when the video is released a year later after everybody has forgotten about it and moved on.
You said that you think that they're trying to hide something. What is it you believe they're trying to hide?
The truth. We believe they're trying to hide the truth.
Right.
But the truth will be revealed. A lie will not be able to stand. We know as we put this puzzle together, the independent autopsy substantiates everything that Khalil and Attorney Lassiter saw on that video.
Everything substantiated. Based on the autopsy, I mean, the death certificate said he died within minutes. Do you believe he suffered for a period of minutes, died?
Yes. Yes. We believe he endured pain and suffering after they executed him here in Elizabeth City, North Carolina.
Those people who claim the sheriff's office has the ability to release either don't know North Carolina law or they are trying to purposely inflame a tragic situation.
Body cameras are shaky and sometimes hard to decipher. They only tell part of the story.
According to the search warrant application, authorities believe Brown was using his home and two vehicles to store, package, and distribute narcotics. The family's attorney says no weapons or drugs were found in Brown's car or in the house at the time.